Hey y'all, welcome to the video tutorial on using the stamp filter. And I really like this filter. I think you can probably come up with some really cool ideas for using this filter. Whether or not it really looks like a rubber stamp, I'm not sure. But maybe you can get creative and find a way to make it look like an actual rubber stamp. So I challenge you to do that. Here's the layout I did. Kind of started out as more of just a saying or a thought thing for a thought book, and it actually turned into a kind of layout, because I do have my journaling and my date down here at the bottom. I went down to the river the other day with a friend, and we just sat there relaxing and taking photos and watching this moon go down. And as the moon went down, the shadow on the water got brighter, and just had a relaxing time. This piece here is what the stamp is on, and it's fairly easy to utilize. I'm going to turn that off. I have an extra copy of it here. Bring that up to the top and turn it on. There's my original photo, and I'm just going to make a bunch of extra copies for us to play with here. This filter does react to the foreground and the background color, and when I did my image, I did pull a dark blue from the water. And I'm going to go ahead and leave white here just so you can see the differences. It's under the sketch category, and it does bring up the, I just realized that my PSC is in full mode, but I think you're okay with that. It does bring up the filter gallery. And you can see here where it has put the white and the, I think the default settings are somewhere in here. So where it has put the white, you know, we have the highlights on the water, and the sky is lighter than this down here. I'm not sure, the sky is pretty dark, so that was a little bit puzzling to me. But that's what it looks like with the white. I am going to go ahead and switch the foreground and background color, and then I'm going to get a lighter blue from the sky, which is what I did for my actual layout that I made. And you can see here what it does when it has the foreground and the background color both in use. And I think I had my foreground and background color switched when I did mine. Now for the, let's move this over so you can see the sliders. Now for the sliders, the light and dark balance, if you move all the way over to the left, you see it turns into black, if you have black and white, or whatever the, let's see, whatever the background color is. And if you move it over, all the way over to the right, it turns to whatever the foreground color is, or it turns to white. And anywhere in between, you see it brings in various amounts of detail. Now, the smoothness slider, if you have it all the way down, which is where I like it, it gives the most detail. But there are reasons, I'll show you some, to move it up, because you get different detail as you move it up. And you can see it becomes much more obscured the further you move it up. Looks much less like a stamp. And there may be some great tutorials out there, maybe for making grunge or something like that, that you would want that smoothness all the way up, but I find I like it down. And then you just click OK, and here's what we get. There is a way to bring back even more detail. If you create a new layer, let me go ahead and make this smaller as I normally record with. There we go. Make a new layer and fill it, you know, with any color. Of course, your colors will, where did my paint bucket go? There it is. Your colors will vary depending on your own purposes. I'm not sure blue is exactly right. Turn on your next layer and go to the filter menu again and bring up that stamp filter. Oh, you see I got two different colors. Let's make this black and white. Hit D on your keyboard to make that black and white. Fill it with the stamp, but keep your smoothness all the way down and keep your darkness pretty far down. And then click OK and then go to the next one. And this time, bring up the sliders just a bit. Smoothness a bit and darkness a bit, so you get something different. And then on another copy of it, on a third copy of it, go ahead and bring that up again. Only this time, go ahead and move the sliders up even more. So you get very little detail. And click OK. Now the trick for each of these is to colorize each of these a different color. And I'm going to bring up Control-U. I'm going to click Colorize, and I'm going to pick a color. I'm going to make it a little bit darker. And here is a, you know, a shade of blue. Actually, I said darker, I meant lighter. A little bit more saturated. There we go, I have a color. Now I'm gonna do the same thing. Click colorize for the next layer, and you have to lighten it up a little bit to get different colors. I'm gonna change it different because my photo is all about blues. And do the same for the next one, but I'm gonna throw something in there just totally random, more like a pink here. How's that? Just so we can see what happens. I'm gonna turn them all on, and I'm gonna reduce the opacity to each of the layers. And as I do, watch what happens up here. You're gonna see it blending in with what's below and bringing some more detail into this stamp. And let's get that third one. So the color actually didn't matter on that third one. It's just a matter of having them three different colors. Because they're all, it's all how they're reacting to your background color. And so I bet you if we change this background color, yeah, it is, it hasn't been, it's not changing the photo a whole lot. See, here it is even green. It seems to be more dependent on this top color. Yes. Here we go. So if I'm wanting more reds or blues, so I want this a little bit more blue, we can group them all together. But probably should have done it the other way. Let's see what happens. Let's turn this back one off. Well, that doesn't work. I was trying to get the blue layer. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so let's undo even further. I think I don't want this blue on the outside, so I guess what I'm going to have to do is gotta get me this activated, inverse it, and delete it out here. There. Now it's the same size as the others. That's what I was going after. Anyway, it's fun to play because you kind of learn when you play. But you can see how it brings back so much more detail when you use it at least three times. You might want to try using it even more and blending it all together. It really looks cool. But if you go back to my original image where I used it only once, you can see what this looks like and what I did with it. And I can't wait to see what you do with it. See if you can maybe even make it like a stamp. What kind of stamps do we have out there? What kind of rubber stamps? We have date stamps. I don't know. We have notary stamps. We have seals, where you would seal something, maybe if your family name has a seal and you put a seal next to something, or a business seal, or I don't know if you would make a seal of a butterfly. I'm thinking seals or circles that you stamp down, or rectangles. I really don't know because I haven't played with that yet. I was just going for something artistic. And so I look forward to seeing what you have to do, and be sure to ask any questions.